So I will cover the basic part of biochemistry structure, their interaction, and side by side the other effects. So basic thing I will cover. So as we know, India has a vast population of poultry that is around 729 million. Out of 2.7 million we have the ton of chicken and 65.48 million egg per year. As we see, so our per capita availability is 54 pieces per year in 2016 and 17. Against the ICR recommendation is 180, and PD poultry ICMR unit already fixed the target around 110 pieces in 2050. Same way, the meat availability of per capita 2.2 kg against ICMR recommendation, that is 8-10 kg, and the fix it has been fixed to around 8.4 kg in 2050. Annual growth rate around 5% of the 5.8%, and that total share is 5% of the global sharing. India ranks third in egg production and 15 chicken. If we see the West Bengal scenario regarding the egg production, we require 2.7 to 2.8 crore eggs per day, but we are producing 1.8 crore per day, and the shortfall is around 1 crore. So that we procure from the adjacent states. And regarding West Bengal scenario, we have the egg productions here of Indian, that is 7.4%, and the leading state are Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh, followed by Telangana. And state-wise, per capita availability is West Bengal 68, against the Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh, that is 13, 12, and 237 for. These are basic statistics, but before going to the subject proper, so I will show one slide where a famous painter, Bruegel, in his painting in 1568, The Beggar, painting itself show that that victim's limbs and the toes, nose, those are consumed by holy fire that blackened like charcoal. So that time he pointed out that it may be due to certain poison or toxin, and it was later on reported that this is the ergotism, which is produced from the Clavicis purpurea fungus, and the poor people who ate the rye bread from there, they got contamination. History like that, in 1960, it was called as turkey disease from the Great Britain, followed by that mycotoxin occurring from poultry farm of Mysore and other part of Karnataka due to sudden death of around 2,000 poultry birds has been reported. Subsequent production of egg from 85% to 40% in one girl district of Andhra Pradesh, now it is in Telangana. Subsequently, it has been found in post-mortem examination that around 600 parts per billion mycotoxin was found in liver lesions. Like in human first report from Banswara district of Rajasthan and Panchamahal district of Gujarat, there also more than 100 people death was reported, and it was found that 2,000 to 6,000 ppb mycotoxin was found in liver. So these are the brief history. As we know, the mycotoxin is a toxin that are produced from different species, and these are classified and from where they are produced. So as we know that aflatoxin, ochratoxin, T2 toxin, citrulline, and like that in alpha toxin, that most target organ is liver, kidney, spleen, testes, and thymus. And the harmful effect, we know that production of egg, anemia, hemorrhage, liver damage, paralysis port, fit conversion ratio, those things are there. And the second most is the ochratoxin, and There are four types. Out of this, type A, OTA is more important, and that the target organs are kidney, liver, and thymus. As we know that all type of toxin generally targets liver, and more or less they suppress the immune system. Others types of toxins are there, zearalenol, ergotism, these are there. So in poultry health, aflatoxin is a major problem, and as we know that more than 20 fungal secondary metabolites, they produce aflatoxin, and they are classified into two biochemical groups. That is, one is aflatoxin B1, B2. This one group is the cyclopentanone groups, and another is the difluorocumarolactone group. These are the basic structure. And if we consider the biochemical actions, how they work on the cellular level, it has been seen that most of the cases that aflatoxin is carcinogenic due to they converts. There are two type of mutation. One is the transition, another is the transversion. So here, the G2T, G mean guanine to thymine. So this purine to pyrimidine base transition is there in DNA. So therefore, it creates the carcinogenic. Different types of aflatoxin degrading enzymes has been isolated, and research was going on. These are few deactivating enzymes that we use in the feeds feed supplements. That one is AFO. This degrades the aflatoxin at 28 degree temperature. Another is the manganese dependent peroxidase. It has been isolated from white rot fungi, and that's activity also around 98%. Next important is the ochratoxin, and out of this, ochratoxin A or OTA is more important. As we know, this ochratoxin, if we see that structure, so it has around two groups. One is phenylalanine moiety, that is on aromatic amino acids, and another is the dihydroisocumarine ring. So this phenylalanine moiety, inhibits the protein synthesis mechanism. So in the first strategy of protein synthesis mechanism, that is tRNA phenyl synthetase. So they inhibit this enzyme, so there is no protein formation. And as this attach with amide bonds, so different type of amidase, different type of proteases deactivates this. This toxin. Mainly, this OTA detoxification pathway, that's hydrolysis of amide bonds. Different type of enzymes, mainly cytochrome. The different type of enzymes like carboxypeptidase A and carboxypeptidase Y have been found to hydrolyze this OTA. Other enzymes are lipase, and I already told that amidase. Next importance is the fumonisins, and this is 1,2,3 tricarboxylic acid and a similar long chain of amino poly backgrounds, and these are structural, they resembles to sphingosine. As we know, the sphingosine is the lipid molecule, and they are the natural structural component in the brain. And this toxin generally inhibits the synthetic pathway by inhibiting one enzyme, is the ceramide synthetase enzyme. These are the structure. Then next, the group come T2 toxin, which is the precursor we call trichothecins, and this having a CQO terpenoid composed of tetracycline ring, and it is generally synthesized of farnesyl pyrophosphates. Farnesyl pyrophosphates also one precursor for cholesterol synthesis. So these are the structure. Under this, type A, T2, H2 is more important. Besides that, DON and NIV. if we look into the cellular mechanism, so it is clearly seen that all are inhibitory effects on the protein synthesis in the left panel, and then increase the systemic cytokines and inhibitory of ceramide synthesis all goes through, goes through into a cycle, and left side the yellow portion, these are one thing, another right portion, that is the impair in the food uptake, ultimately improper growth of this of the poultry birds. If we see the incidence of mycotoxin throughout globe, the one leading company is the Biomin from Germany. They actually made a survey in 2017, and the picture itself show that distribution of or contamination of mycotoxin throughout the globes. If we consider the effect of mycotoxin in poultry health, so effect is like that feed intake is reduced by 12%, body weight reduced by 14%, mortality in case of dawn, it is increased by 8.8%, aflatoxin in case of aflatoxin, it is 2.8. And due to the these havoc effects, the organ weights generally increases, like liver 15%, kidney 11%, lungs 9%, gizzard 3%. The same things here given. So if we see the poultry products, so different type of that mycotoxin have a different target organs, like aflatoxin, as we know, liver, generally known eggs, okra in eggs, DOV in eggs, like that. This is another basic mechanism how aflatoxin is degraded, that is cytochrome P 45 pathway, as we know, and compound is AFBO, which causes actually DNA damage by conversion. Effect of this aflatoxin in poultry health, so if we see that it will increase the maturity in layer, and also reduce in egg production. Egg quality parameter like egg yolk and the egg albumin, it affects cell thickness. Besides that, we know that immune system, like the immune cells, from where immune cells are produced, immune organ like bursa of Fabricius, thymus, spleen, these are depressed, so that CD4, CD8 lymphocytes count is reduced, and the antibody titer like IgG, IgM, and the IgA has been reduced. It has also found that this aflatoxin actually causes decreased uptake of nutrient, as it damages the crypt of the jejunum and the villus of the duodenum. So the actual, if it damages the intestine or duodenum, from where the major portion of the nutrient got absorbed into the blood, so it becomes affects the that nutrient. And also, as we know that this aflatoxin and more of the mycotoxin is transmitted into the eggs, so the hatchability of egg become a problem. And if you see the physical symptoms or clinical symptom, that defects in tarsal, defects in tibial growth plates, so that the bone or legs become deformed. So these are basic, and we generally diagnose this thing on the basis of symptoms, postmortem findings, and we have the certain test in our laboratory, that is the lateral flow immune chromatography assay, and to some extent also we developed the HPLC high performance liquid chromatography technique to diagnose this. So if we see this picture, effect of this toxin, how the color changes, if that concentration increases, it become pale and in severe concentration it will be very fatal. In our laboratory we have two sort of techniques. One is lateral flow immunochromatography technique, that is totally depend on the on kind of immune assay. So here simple, we pass through the sample. First we prepare the sample with 70% to 30% methanol water vortex and pass through filter paper, and then we have the strip, lateral flow strip, to check rapid flow kit whether that level of toxicity we have kept as 4 ppb cutoff value. So in case of there are two types of line, actually I'll show you here. So down that strip shows actually one line means it is above 4 ppb level. If it is two lines, it will be below 4 ppb. And another system is the HPL system, where we use the 2487 fluorescence detector. As we know, this compound is detected through fluorescence detector, and we have only standardized the aflatoxin beyond component as it is major problem. So side by side we are trying to standardize other component as ocratoxin and other component of mycotoxin like B2G1 and G2. Different times we receive sample, though it is a very less or scanty amount of sample, we request different state poultry farm to send sample for and even other private farm to send sample for mycotoxin, mainly aflatoxin analysis. So these are the sample we receive, Barodan, Poultry, Malda, private duck farm, and that Amrit Hatchery. And less you can see, most of the cases it is less than 4 ppb. When it crosses the 4 ppb level, so those sample we run in the HPLC system. This is another 2017-18, like poultry farm Baliguri, Amrit Hatchery, State Duck Poultry Farm, Poshim Midnapur, Kusvihar, Tollygons, and Horingata Farm. Most of the cases that it is less than 4 ppb, and when it is crossed the 4 ppb, we run the sample in HPLC. Also, we analyze the sample other than our state. In 2016-17, we got some sample from Tripura, Agartala, Sikkim, Kotok, that is duck breeding farm, Kapuria, and the Angol poultry breeding and research farm. So all the cases, it was less than 4 ppb. These are the diagnosis portion. Now if we, mycotoxin is a problem for poultry health. If we, it is not a solution, we diagnose, we give a postmortem report, this is the symptom, this is not a problem. We have to design a strong control strategy. So for that, first we have to see, this is the mycotoxin screening. I have already discussed that if feed sample goes to the end user, they should screen through our laboratory, or they can even standardize in their own farm also with the lateral flow immunochromatography assay. Besides that, monitoring and control of moisture prevent the fungal growth. As we know that most of the cases, we have also proximate analysis lab where we analyze the different type of feed sample, and most of the cases it has been found that that moisture is below 10%. So that level it is not a problem. So if moisture percentage increases, that is creates a problem in mycotoxin growth. And it has been found that no toxin produced at a temperature of 5 to 8 degrees centigrade. Besides that, so the accessories for handling that feed for poultry, so that should be cleaned periodically with 5 to 10% bleaching. Control strategy, one of the control strategies is the pre-harvest strategy. So in case of pre-harvest strategy, one of the major thing that we have to think about, this is the century where research has been developed. So we can think about the certain type of maize crop which does not produce any mycotoxin. So this is one research article where they cited that if we knock down the polyketide synthetase gene, which mainly produce the aflatoxin in case of aflatoxin, so there will be the production, nil production of mycotoxin. On these cases, those type of transgenic maize we can use for the feed formulation so that the next downstream processing, preservation, and in case of end use, there will be no problem of that aflatoxin. Then other things are post-harvest decontamination method and amelioration of biological inactivation. Different type of physical decontaminant agent has been reported. These are called antimycotic agents. Out of these, sorbic acid, propionate, benzoate has been found. Even the acetic acid prevents the mold growth. Besides that, different type of herbs have been reported, like cinnamon, oil, cloves, garlic, those having an antimycotic property. Different type of chemical detoxification agents which we are used. Suppose we got certain type of feed sample which are heavily mycotoxic, mycotoxin or alpha toxic contaminated, that time it is a problem for disposal. For that, we in our laboratory have practiced that ammoniation solution we have, and we keep it on the ammonial solution or 0.5% sodium hydroxide, which destroy this detoxifying, that will help as reduce the mycotoxin load. Different type of mycotoxin binder has been circulated in the market. Out of this activated charcoal and that bentonite, that is hydrated aluminum silicate, that HS gas and cholestyramine, those have been found to have a strong mycotoxin binding effect. And these are the ratio against aflatoxin. It will reduce by 95% if we use activated charcoal, and ochratoxin 91%. Then in case of HSA, that is 0.5% of HS gas effective against aflatoxin. Different type of antioxidant also found to reduce the mycotoxin or aflatoxin load. This is mainly vitamin C, different phenolic compound, vitamin E with selenium, and vitamin A. Different food additives have been also reported to reduce the mycotoxin load or aflatoxin load. Out of that, aspartate, crude protein, then L-phenylalanine, as we show that L-phenylalanine we give, so that effect of OTA can be overcome. Different type of dietary lipid also found. Anyhow, future roadmap, we have to design some experiment where we can produce aflatoxin free transgenic maize using host-inducing gene silencing, and we can approach the metabolic approaches and genomic transcriptome and proteomic approaches like ultra high performance liquid chromatography, mass tandem, MALDI TOF assay to see the total profile of the mycotoxin. This is the maize cell where we designed the, not that researcher designed the RNA cassette during that transfer, it will go to the fungi and it will bind the polyketide synthetase RNA and it inactivates the aflatoxin production. So this is the metabolic and genomic approach and proteomics approach. Thank you.